President Trump has requested Guantanamo Bay to get ready for approaching abnormal state detainees, including American government officials, inside the following couple of months. As indicated by a Military of Defense report, Trump is getting ready to exchange an obscure number of VIP American prisoners to the famous jail in readiness for their trials, previously a U.S. military tribunal. Reports recommend that individuals associated with the Uranium One outrage are being set in authority in readiness for the trials. Several U.S. Army military police have additionally been conveyed to Cuba to help administer the procedure. As indicated by the DoD report, while leading routine preparing missions in Cuba, caught an abnormally vast number of scrambled interchanges radiating between the Guantanamo Bay Naval Base, Cuba, and Luke Air Force Base, Arizona, instantly after which they made a demand to SVR counterintelligence examiners for a clarification of, with the SVR, thus, at that point answering to SCT that these correspondences were being led between the Guantanamo Military Commission, that holds U.S. military tribunals, and U.S. Attorney General's Jeff Sessions. On April 11, 2017, likewise, this report says, the SVR answered to SCT that Attorney General Sessions was at Luke Air Force Base to hold, lead gatherings with different administrators of the Arizona Army National Guard, AZRNG, with the longest of them being with the commandants of the 850th Military Police Battalion, that numbers almost 800 profoundly prepared and concentrated U.S. Army military police powers. Since its start on April 11, 2017, this report proceeds with, SCT captures of correspondences between Guantanamo Bay Naval Base and Luke Air Force Base proceeded on an extraordinary premise, with the biggest measure of such interchanges being accounted for on July 7, 2017, and was the date Attorney General Sessions and Deputy Attorney General Rod Rosenstein influenced an unannounced visit to the Guantanamo Strait Naval Base, and whose gatherings there on that date incorporated the officers of the 850th Military Police Battalion who had been flown there the day earlier. The particular kind of correspondence blocks noted by SCT happening between Guantanamo Bay Naval Base and Luke Air Force Base, this report subtle elements, or encoded video satellite communicates transmitted at the North American standard rate of 59.94 casings for every second, and whose close unsurprising circumstances of transmission recommended, to SVR investigators, that these video communicates were being utilized for classroom direction. On December 21, 2017, this report additionally notes, SCT announced that about these correspondences between Guantanamo Bay Naval Base and Luke Air Force Base had stopped, with the SVR detailing that this end happened when U.S. Defense Secretary James Distraught Dog Mattis made a remarkable unannounced visit to Guantanamo, the principal visit there by a U.S. Defense Secretary in almost 16 years, and that in doing, Secretary Mattis shockingly broke with the long-standing convention of people holding his high office going by American troops on the cutting edges, however that he regarded his sudden visit to Guantanamo was imperatively more critical than. Furthermore, in the matter of how essentially critical Secretary Mattis considered his uncommon visit to Guantanamo, this report says, ended up plainly known yesterday, December 29, 2017, when President Trump all of a sudden requested the whole 850th Military Police Battalion to promptly send from Luke Air Force Base to Guantanamo Bay Naval Base. With the Guantanamo Bay detention camp holding just 41 prisoners, yet ready to hold almost 800, this report notes, President Trump's all of a sudden requesting there such an expansive number of U.S. military police powers requires a further clarification regarding why, and which the SVR says can be found in the similarly sudden movement of the cryptic IBC Airways, and whom, upon President Trump's requesting the 850th Military Police Battalion to instantly send to Guantanamo, declared, on December 29, 2017, that it is expanding its flights to Naval Station Guantanamo Bay to 3 times each week, hence very proposing its expectation of a surge of guests there, well on the way to incorporate American lawyers safeguarding their destined to be detained traitorous customers. To the probability of President Trump really detaining his profound state foes, who are as of now occupied with an overthrow against him, General Staff Deputy Defense Minister Tatiana Shevtsova in this report lays out the trail that Trump's been following since he initially took office, and whose pieces of information can be found in his outrageous screening migration design, the long history of which his adversaries have overlooked to their hazard. Despite the fact that not known to the American individuals, this report clarifies, profound state-adjusted radical U.S. federal judges have been doing combating Trump over his outrageous screening plan since the very week he took office, with their reason being on the grounds that Trump has attested his energy to act in light of a standout amongst the most dubious and slightest comprehended laws in the historical backdrop of the United States, that is known as McCarran Act, or Internal Security Act of 1950, that considers the confinement of perilous, traitorous, or subversive people in the midst of war or interior security crisis. As establishing FBI Director J. Edgar Hoover had cautioned the U.S. Congress in the late 1940s that it just took 23 commies to topple Russia, this report proceeds with, "The Internal Security Act of 1950 was instituted into law so as to shield the American president and government from an interior upset like the one Trump is currently confronting, and that President Trump, on December 21, 2017, precisely the same Secretary Mattis made his sudden visit to Guantanamo, authorized the main period of by his marking an executive order proclaiming that America, in reality, was presently in a province of national emergency, with his precisely naming, as well, the Hillary Clinton-connected people trying to oust the U.S. government. For the most part obscure to the American individuals when President Trump captures and confines for U.S. military tribunal trials in Guantanamo these profound state-upset plotters, this report additionally notes, is that it was really President Barack Obama who, in 2012, marked this presidential power into law with the dreaded National Defense Authorization Act, and that approves the uncertain military detainment, without charge or trial, of any individual named a combative, including an American native. Similarly obscure to most by far of the American individuals, as well, this report finishes up, is that the present profound state upset plot against President Trump isn't the first their country has confronted either, yet is, actually, its second, with the first being in 1933 when the profound state propelled the business plot coup against President Franklin Roosevelt altogether so they could join the United States with the globalist-controlled Nazi Germany, with this overthrow plot being driven by the Nazi-adjusted Bush family, yet with this upset being obliterated by U.S. Marine General Smedley Butler, whose relentless shoes U.S. Marine General James Frantic Dog Mattis now remains in so he, as well, may spare his country.